Leviathan, Thomas Hobbes delivers a political argument in three parts. A way of thinking about human nature and society, he believes reveals political truths that will ensure civic peace. Part one of Leviathan is called Of Man. Hobbes focuses on the nature of people and discusses the main points of the argument he will expand upon in the other sections of the book. He explores those human qualities that distinguish people, man, from other animals, particularly regarding their capacity to reason and use verbal communication. He enumerates common human virtues and defects and explains how human curiosity and creativity have led to culture in human society, particularly to the development of science and religion. Because humans have determined that a state of peace is valuable for a longer, satisfying life, they've used reason to figure out ways to ensure such social stability, creating a social contract of laws embedded in a governmental structure. In part two, Of Commonwealth, Hobbes explains the different kinds of commonwealth, explaining his own preferences for what he believes are more successful. Hobbes is thorough in his enumeration of the elements necessary to a well-functioning commonwealth, and he explains the function, illustrating how the parts of such a governmental structure correspond to the parts of the monster, the Leviathan. He also takes time to consider elements in human society that threaten the commonwealth and how to deal with them. The greatest threat of all to a commonwealth is civil war, and he's quite direct in providing advice for how to avoid such a catastrophe. Finally, in part three of A Christian Commonwealth, Hobbes claims that the most secure path to peace is a society founded on Christian principles. Hobbes's thorough knowledge of the Bible is apparent in his detailed analysis of its concepts. It's particularly important to Hobbes to prove that a life of devoted Christian faith is compatible with a life of reason. The last four chapters of part three are sometimes treated separately as a part four of the Kingdom of Darkness. In these final chapters, Hobbes discusses the corrupting worldly forces in the religious sector, particularly in the Roman Catholic Church, that create a kingdom of darkness on earth. As a proponent of enlightenment through reason, Hobbes warns against charlatans who may try to manipulate people by terrifying them with threats of demons.